G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I've got another composite for you. It is five different photos that's going to make up this apocalyptic looking picture that we have on the screen here. I'm going to start by creating a new template, and the one that I want to do, I'm going to use is this social media square post template, 1080 by 1080. Just going to hit a create on that one. We're going to get this starting point here, which is the size of 1080 by 1080 with a transparent background. I'm going to move that all the way to the front here so we can start off with this picture. The first thing I'm going to do is fill this with black. You could either do it two ways. You could add a new pixel layer and use your fill and fill it with black, but I'm going to use my rectangle tool here. On the fill up here, I'm going to choose black on my swatches here, and then I'm just going to drag out that rectangle on to that transparent background and just make sure it all snaps into place. And it's a lot easier if you have your snapping turned on up here. So once we've got our black background, we can start adding all our other elements. So the next element that I'm going to add is going to be the city here, the cityscape. So I'm just going to Command C and come back to our black background and Command V. I'm going to make sure I'm on my move tool here. Use my command minus just to make everything a little bit smaller, and then I can resize that city and then hit command zero. While we've got our city here, let's add a live filter down here in our live filters. Let's add a depth of field. Let's hit preserve alpha so we don't mess up our edges here. And let's just take our radius up to about five pixels roughly. Make this little circle here a little bit smaller. This gives a little bit of a blur into the back of the city here. Now the next photo that we're going to bring over is a picture of this brick wall here, and as you can see, I've already selected the wall using the selection brush tool here, getting as close as possible to the top of the wall here. So all I'm going to do with this one again is Command C, take it over to my picture here that we're creating, and Command V. Again, we can use our Command minus to make that really small, and then bring in these to make it a little bit smaller into our picture. And again, Command zero to bring our picture back up. It's going to move our wall into place, and I'm just going to move it just on the picture here so we can't see this edge anymore. So we're going to bring it about here, which looks pretty good. And I want to get this picture blending in a little bit better to the background here. So on the brick wall picture, I'm going to add a mask down here. Clicking on the mask, I'm actually going to get the gradient tool, clicking on the gradient, and on our fill box here, I'm going to click on the fill box. And I'm going to go to the swatches, make sure that this says gradient, and I'm looking for the gradient that goes white to black. That's this one here, white to black. So that's going to make that wall disappear, but that's okay. We're just going to start here and drag this down, and as you can see, we're going from white to black. Just going to drag that down, bring this white one just below the wall here, and then with our little slider here, I'm going to bring the black back in. So we have got all that green disappearing. You can see some of the cities coming through there, so I'll just bring this white down a little bit more and then bring that black up. So we've just sort of got all the black over the bottom of that picture, and I'm happy with that. So I'm going to click on the little hand tool here just to get those changes in there. While I've got my wall picture here, I am going to add a levels on my adjustments here. So down to levels and clip that levels layer just to the wall. And on the levels, I'm just going to bring the blacks up on that wall a little bit as well. Okay, to about 16 looks pretty good. You can have a play and see where you end up, but that's not looking too bad. So we've got our city and we've got our wall. We can also, on our wall here, just grab this little blur tool again and click on the blur tool. The hardness is about 66 or 60% would be fine. And the others, the opacity and the flow, are at 100. And we can just make our brush a little bit smaller. Let's just blur the top of that wall a little bit just so it blends in a little bit better. Along the top of the wall there, not too much. Just getting that blending in a little bit better there. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, the next picture that I'm going to bring in is the picture of my man in the gas mask here. And again, you can see that I've used my selection brush tool. Just made a selection just around the man, just this part of the man. We don't need the background. So again, we can go Command C, back over to our picture, and Command V. Clicking on our Move tool, use our Command minus again to go really small and bring our man into place. Making that just big enough to come into the picture. Again, Command 0 to make it back to the normal size. I want my man in the corner here. I'm going to drag him down a little bit bigger. And I'm just going to sit him in the corner. Drag that up a little bit more. And that's not looking too bad. You can resize it a little bit more if you want. While I've got my man here, I am going to grab this little blur tool again. Same percentages on all of the opacity, flow, and hardness. And again, I'm just going to go around the edges of the man just to blend him in a little bit better. That's not looking too bad. I'm going to add a levels adjustment to the man as well and clip that to the man. And we're going to bring the blacks up fairly high to about 13, just so that makes it really dark. But on that levels adjustment, I'm going to invert it with a Command I. So just Command I to invert it. Let's grab our brush over here. Make sure we're on a nice basic soft brush, making sure we've got our colors back to default by hitting D on the keyboard. And we're going to make sure we're painting in white. And we're just going to paint some of that levels adjustment onto our man here, making that a bit blacker. We'll want to see some of that texture coming through. So that's looking pretty good. Got a bit of a sharp edge on our man here. So I will add a mask to our man. On our mask, we want to make sure we've got a nice soft basic brush. We want to get our colors back to default. You can hit D on your keyboard, which will take the colors back to default. Grab our brush. I've got a flow of about 20%, and let's make sure we're painting in black, and let's just get rid of that harsh edge there a little bit. Not looking too bad. So we've got rid of that harsh edge. If you're taking too much, you can make your brush a little bit smaller and go back to white by hitting X on your keyboard and just bring a little bit of that back as well. And that's looking pretty good. So back on our man again here, we're going to add another adjustment, and this time we're going to add an exposure. Again, let's clip the exposure to the man, and on that exposure level here, I'm going to bring that up quite bright to about 2.7, 2.6, 2.7 looks pretty good. And on the exposure level, I'm going to invert that again, so Command I to invert that exposure level. I'll grab my brush again. I'm happy with my flow at 25%. I want my color here to be in white. White reveals, black conceals. But on white here, just with my brush, I'm just going to paint in the eye there a little bit just to put the exposure and highlight that eye and bring that eye so we can see it a little bit better. And I'm happy with that where the eye is at the moment. We can see it through the mask. So there we go. We've got our man in our picture. We've got our brick wall and our city. So the next picture that I'm going to use in my composite here, I like this gas mask and I like just the front bit of this gas mask. So I'm just going to use that. And as you can see, I've used my elliptical marquee tool here and just drawn a circle around just the part of this gas mask that I want to use. So again, I'm going to go Command C. Bring it over to my picture here that I'm creating and Command V. Again, back on our Move tool, and let's make that a lot smaller and see where we're going to fit it in place here. See how big we want it. So let's just go a little bit smaller. That is not looking too bad, about there, maybe a little bit smaller, fitting it into place. Okay, it's sort of a little bit skew whiff as well, so I'm going to click over here on my perspective tool and I'm just going to bring that back, sort of hopefully get it back in a little bit of a better perspective. Not too bad. Let's put a mask on that as well. Back to our brush. We're still okay at 25%, and this time we want to be painting in black. So I'm going to swap these colors over with the X on my keyboard, making my brush a little bit smaller. And I'm just going to take away those little bits that shouldn't be there. Maybe a little bit around here. And then we can close this up. I'm going to add a levels adjustment. Again, clipping that just to that section here and bringing those blacks all the way up. Okay, click back on this little section here as well. And we'll use our blur tool here. And I'm just going to blur that in a little bit more as well to try and get that fitting in a little bit better. So next, we're going to add our virus. And this is a picture of a planet and a virus that I've blended together earlier, and I will make this picture available to you for download as well. So let's go Command C, over to our picture again, and Command V. On our move tool again, let's go Command minus so we can make that a lot smaller and bring our virus picture in. Again, Command 0 to make it bigger. And I'm going to drop the opacity to about 50% and just move that into place. I want it sort of coming over the city. Once we've got the virus in place, we're going to add a mask to our virus. And clicking on the mask, we'll grab our brush tool again. Our flow 25%, opacity 100, and hardness 0 is still good. We want to make sure we're on a nice, soft, basic brush. And we want our color to be black because we're going to start painting some of this virus out. Along here, we could have masked the city and then just brought that to the front, but I think this is probably not too bad. I just want to see the city, and that's looking okay at the moment. So let's make our brush a lot smaller. Let's zoom all the way in with our Command Plus, and then let's just hold our Shift key and drag that down so we can see quite a bit of it. Making my brush a bit smaller, I'm going to swap colors now with my X back to white so we can paint some of that back in. And I just found this a little bit easier than masking out the whole city and a lot quicker. And since we're sort of going to just have it in the background, it's not too bad. So I'm just making my brush just the size I need to go in between those buildings there. And over here as well, maybe a little bit bigger. Doesn't matter if we get a little bit of overspill. And actually, in fact, we can bring those ones so they look like they're coming in front of the city. And a little bit down here. And we'll just fix that up as we go along. Make my brush a little bit bigger down the side here. That one we can bring back as well. Just in front of those buildings. Take your time with this. I'm sort of rushing it a little bit, but you can take a little bit more time. Those ones that look like they're behind there, we can bring that one back in so it looks like it's in front of the building, sneaking over the top. And there we go. Let's just go Command 0. I am going to click on that and bring that opacity down quite a bit more, maybe to about 20%, looking pretty good. And there we go. We've got quite a lot of our elements in place. So now we just have to add our colors. So what I'm going to do is just click on the breathing apparatus that we brought over first and come down to adjustments, and I'm going to hit recolor. Again, I'm just going to clip that just to this section here, and I'm going to bring the hue up to about 110. I'm going to bring the saturation down to about 34. This has given me the sort of that greeny apocalyptic color that I'm looking for, about 34, and minus 6 on the lighting. So now I've got that color done once, I'm going to add it to all the other pictures as well. I'm doing it individually just so I have a little bit more control of each of the pictures here. So just clicking on that recolor and Command J, and I'm going to drag one of them down onto my man. Then on the man here where I've got my recolor, I'm going to hit Command J again to copy that and drag one down onto my wall, just making my wall green. And this is where I can play with this a little bit and just bring the saturation down on the wall a little bit, and maybe the lighting a tiny little bit as well, looking a little bit better on the wall. And also we're going to add the recolor as well, Command J again, and I'm going to add that to my city. I've got the green on my city. So I've got that color on all of my pictures here. I may just tweak my wall, just clicking on that recolor. I might just add a little bit more brightness on that wall and then click off. There we go. Okay, I'm going to add my text now. So right on top, we're going to put our text. I'm going to come over here to my text, drag that out, and then write the words run. You can write any word that you like. And then I'm going to highlight that text. I'm going to change the color of the text to white. And then over here, I'm going to change from aerial to impact. So I'm just going to come down to impact. And then change the size to make that a little bit bigger. Might click in here and make it about 240. That's not too bad. So let's move that right down to the bottom. And I'm going to drag it all the way across. That text layer should be right on top, all the way on top. And I might drag that down a little bit as well. That's not looking too bad. Going to make this text look a little bit more apocalyptic. I'm saying that 10 times in a row. Click on my text layer here and add a mask. On the mask, I'm going to come to my brushes and change it to sprays and splatters. And just pick one of these sprays and splatters onto my brush here. Color should be on black. Going to make this a little bit smaller. Going to start adding some of these sprays to the bottom of my picture here, maybe a couple on the top, just add many as you like, and just add a few more. I'm going to change the brush again now to maybe a smaller splatter, maybe something like this, and add some more splatters. You add as many as you like, we'll just do that for now. And on that text now, I'm going to drop the opacity all the way down to about 20%. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is click on our text here. Holding our shift key down, we're going to click on all of the layers. Coming over here to layer and merge visible. That'll give us one layer on top here. And now we're going to add our noise with our filters, noise, add noise. And I'm going to take that up to about 30% and click apply. There's a few more things we'll do to this picture. So clicking on that layer we just created, which is all of these layers now into one layer, going to come over here to my tone mapping persona. And on my tone compression here, I'm turning that all the way down. And then I'm going to add a little bit of contrast here, maybe about 15, and it gives us that really gritty look. And that's the look I want, that really gritty look. And let's hit apply. So the very, very last thing, okay, on top here, we'll add a curves layer. So let's come down to curves, right on top, in the middle of our curves, and let's pull that down so it's a lot darker. So there we go, everybody. That is my composite, my apocalyptic looking composite using 5 different photos, creating it on a template that is for the social media size of 1080 by 1080, which should be perfect for like Instagram and Facebook. So if you enjoyed the tutorial this week, please subscribe to my channel. Please give me a thumbs up, hit that little notification bell so you know when I upload my next video. But until then, I will say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.